On stage, a ballet dancer is serene, elegant, and measured. But behind the scenes, it's a different story.
Do this. Derek says this is what it is. Do it.
With unprecedented access to English National Ballet, one of the UK's elite dance companies, this series will reveal what it takes to put on a world-class ballet.
You want from me more, and you have to repeat again and again.
Go, 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 go.
From the turbulent production of Swan Lake.
Listen to the shoes, elephants.
And the battles of Romeo and Juliet.
Already this week we have three guys off.
This is terrifying.
To the struggles of creating a brand new Nutcracker.
Ballet's not finished. We ain't finished.
You'll survive this. I don't survive bad reviews.
With the future of the arts in doubt, this is a company fighting for its life.
That's nearly £700,000 a year that we have to find.
I think you should be worrying about whether they're going to cut dancing.
From injury and defeat...
I need to save my feet for tomorrow.
..to success and elation.
Very good.
God almighty.
Will English National Ballet survive one of its toughest years? English National Ballet is a touring company with its headquarters in Kensington, West London. The 64 dancers, made up of 20 nationalities, rehearse daily to produce large-scale classical ballet around the world. The man charged with shaping the artistic direction of the company is Wayne Eagling.
Of all the people that I know, English National Ballet are the hardest working dancers. We do well over 120, 130 shows a year. In classical ballet, it's the most demanding, I think, of dance forms. You push your body to such extremes.
One of the dancers in class is Daria Klementova from the Czech Republic. She is the company's most experienced and longest serving prima ballerina.
I've been doing it for 20 years professionally now. I'm actually quite an old ballerina now and I'm still dancing, so it's quite an achievement. I had three operations on my knees. I had one on my ankle and had a baby as well. I've done everything I could. It's been a bit used and abused.
Put a weight on it.
I just did this morning class, and after class I was warming up for my rehearsal, and everything was fine, and suddenly I got like terrible pain here, like in my ankle going up here, and I tried to go on point and I basically couldn't put my weight on it. It hurts here, like up to here. Well, what I want to achieve next is I just would like to dance a little bit longer and be healthy and not being injured, and try to enjoy it as much as I can for another, I don't know, few years, 2 years, 1 year. I really don't know. It just still hurts. Old ballerina crying.
At 38, Daria is nearing the end of her career. But Russian dancer Vadim Montagirov's is just beginning. He's arrived from ballet school to begin his first professional contract at the company.
Is it your birthday?
Yeah.
Happy birthday! Thank you.
I'm 20 years old, I'm really young. This is my sixth month in company. I can say I'm a really shy person. I should be a bit more confident, but I don't know, it's coming. On stage, sometimes I'm more confident than in real life, in normal life. When I talk to someone, sometimes I feel like, oh, I'm not interesting or something like that. I'm saying something wrong or something.
Over the next few weeks, Vadim faces a heavy schedule of rehearsals, including extra half-hour stage calls, But being new to the company, he's still learning discipline.
Vadim, what time is the half? No, 5 to 7. There was a rehearsal at 5 to 7. It's not 14 minutes past 7. You were employed by this company to be here at the half. There's going to be a report spread about this, that you have not turned up for the half. We've been here, you have not been here. It's unprofessional.
You have the possibility, I think you begin to realise, but you have the possibility to be a, you know, international star. But you need to listen.
You never can really give up a bit or like take it easy. So every time if you're late or something, they tell you straight away. But I get a bit trouble, but I think it's good sometimes to be troubled, so someone kind of pushing you, so after that I start working even harder.
Wayne has chosen Swan Lake at the Royal Albert Hall as the company's next production to rehearse, one of the biggest and most lucrative shows of the year, which is choreographed by Derek Dean.
I have this reputation for being tough. The difficulty for me, every time we reproduce this production, is getting the absolute 100% commitment out of the dancer, emotionally and physically, so that they will almost bleed for me.
Derek has chosen Vadim to perform the leading role on opening night, and it's their first rehearsal together.
Ah, how are you?
Good, thank you.
This boy, I'd heard about him. I was worried. He was very raw, he was very young, but with this phenomenal physical technique, which is very impressive, but it's not the whole package.
Right, well, we better start.
I just decided to take a chance and just see what could be done with this boy in the short time.
It's very difficult when you're working with somebody so young, you see, because you just don't know how much to push, you know, because he's got all this talent and he's got all the ability and all the possibilities. And if you just push him too fast, too early, you can damage him. But if you don't push him enough, you don't get to the limit of what he's got at the moment, you know.
Why don't you try some things from the first act solo? Plink, plonk, one, long. No. Just stand in arabesque without the leg up. Out the leg up, long. Look, you see, it's dead. I want to see something in here, yeah. Separate the fingers, that's nicer. For you, that's nice. You get this slightly sausage look, do you know what I mean? First, I wanted a more experienced dancer because of the ballerina that's coming to the company to dance it, Paulina Semyonova. You know, she's in the top three dancers in the whole world, and so she needs a partner to level up to her.
Guest star, Paulina Semyonova, previously danced the leading role at the Royal Albert Hall to rave reviews in one of Derek's last Swan Lake productions. But she's unavailable for rehearsals. So Vadim must practice with Daria, who has recovered from her ankle injury.
Ah, I see immediately that hair. She's gonna get rid of that, isn't she?
So sorry. My watch is like 2 minutes before 12.
In the story, Vadim plays the part of a prince in love with Odette, a princess turned into a swan by an evil sorcerer.
Who's that? Now here, slide. Now go, pull her this way, pull away.
Because the audience get further and further away in such a big place like the hall, my most difficult thing was to get the emotion and the feeling and the drama and the story across to the back of the gallery.
Now, give in, have a look, and have a look.
and say no, 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 no. Okay. It's got to make sense. It's all got to make sense. The important thing for me always, as you very well know, is the reason you do it. Why you're scared, why you're trying to fly away. Because it's all the story, you see. We've got to get as much as that back in. Because nobody does it anymore. And we have to get it. Down, up. Down, up. It's just a little bit floaty. We've got to put the ideas back in, put the story back in, so you're not predictable. Same again. I spend most of my time trying to, well, I just, you know, pull it out of dancers' heads and bodies. And I drive people mad. I drive people absolutely mad.
Good.
And I will never change.
No. You're much too early. You're so unmusical.
It's at the end of the phrase you come in. What are you finding problematic? You have no idea. You have no idea?
Working with Derek, I think it's, he worked really hard. He screams. Sometimes you not feel comfortable what he's saying, but you can't say anything because it's true.
Same again.
He remind me the teachers from Russia.
Vadim began ballet dancing at 7 years old. His training became serious at 9, when he left home to join the Perm Ballet School in Minsk, Russia, which produces some of the world's greatest dancers.
They just scream at us, like sometimes just smack us in the legs, and then I really scared my teacher. Every time he go in the studio, I was standing like that. Every time I tried to do steps perfectly, so he not gonna scream at me. We're just so scared. I remember the teacher we have, he was really tall. He was 2 meters tall. We were 10 years old, little boys, and he was screaming at us, work hard, hard. Like, you hate the teachers as well, but later you understand what they give you, your life, your job.
~60% of English National Ballet's annual £12 million budget is provided by government funding to tour ballet around the country.
Oh, stray dancers, this could mean classes over.
But since the coalition government came into power, managing director Craig Hassel fears arts funding might be cut.
Well, let's try and get through that quickly, and then we have like 40 minutes for this. So we need to talk about the just the implications of the cuts. If it can be before next week, that'd be great.
All we know about the result of the election is that the coalition has said that it has to cut spending drastically across all sectors. So of course that will affect funding for the arts. So we could just wait till the axe falls and we see how we're supposed to survive in the new funding climate, or we could be a bit proactive and look at a few scenarios.
The company are reliant on the funding provided by the government to pay nearly 200 staff and dancers. But with the future uncertain, Craig discusses the options with the heads of departments.
I mean, for us it's quite simple. We either tour less or make fewer new shows. That's kind of it, without cutting into the bone of the company. If we can't afford to survive going forward by doing those two things, reducing those things, then we start looking at, well, are we talking about fewer members of staff, you know, fewer dancers, fewer members of the orchestra? The problem with that, I think, is once you start talking about fewer dancers or, you know, cutting artistic quality, then it's kind of the beginning of the end.
Because then we'll lose all our good dancers. The hard part of the job is creating a vibrant artistic company.
Mm.
And you can't, you know, and you may have some failures. At the same time, the Arts Council wants innovation and new things. It does cost money.
See you later.
If I were to hold a meeting with the company now and say, OK, everyone, new government, funding cuts are looming, we're going to have to make some changes around here, that would send panic into the company. We'll work on this quietly and work out a solution. It's almost like a dirty little secret.
For the company, the show must go on, and Derek's epic Swan Lake production needs a large cast of 140 dancers, but there are only 64 in the company. So extra freelance dancers have been hired to make up the numbers.
Well,
Rachel Ware from Ryslip is one of the chosen few.
It can be hard because if you've trained for most of your life and then you don't get a permanent contract, you're just doing little jobs here and there. It's getting the money to then keep your classes going and keep training, because that's the hard thing. You don't realise, I suppose, until you come out of the school that it's the finances of keeping that up.
Well, Rachel has just trained all her life, really, to become a ballet dancer. Her day is on her own. She doesn't have any friends around her. And I think she has to be really dedicated, disciplined.
Obviously, the dream is to get a permanent contract with them. Just, there's so much competition out there and everyone's kind of fighting for the same few spaces.
Rachel has just 6 weeks to prove to the ballet staff she can play a swan. If she succeeds and lasts the Swan Lake season, she might earn a full-time position in the company.
Got to be in line, you have to be, if you're the one out of line, then you're screamed at. And they say to you, you know, if you're told anything twice, you're out. So all that kind of bit scares me.
So many people in the centre, there's no order where you stand. You literally have to push yourself to the front to do the exercise, and that's not really what I'm that good at.
Any mistakes, I'll throw you out. There's quite a few that are straight from schools, so it's very difficult for them. They've done an end of school show maybe, but that's the only experience they've had. So they do have to mature very quickly.
Close side, one, passe. Back, front, first head away, first head towards, and fifth, soutenu. One to the side, one side. Am I going too quick?
If they're not on board with us straight away, then we've got replacements, you know, so we'll start dragging some of those in to see if they're any better.
These extra dancers will be paid £350 a week for the privilege of performing in Swan Lake. But the work is welcome, as ballet jobs are infrequent and often poorly paid.
I don't know how anyone survived. I don't know. Like, some of the girls in the company had second jobs. Like, a lot of them had second jobs. That's how little.
Like, worked in a cafe and stuff.
No, like worked. Like worked in the clubs. Like,
oh really? Oh my gosh!
I know. Like exotic dancers.
Really?
Yeah.
Nice.
Tomorrow we have class earlier, then we have rehearsal all day, and we're starting to choreograph the swans with the whole of the company, so that would be amazing to be in the same rehearsal as all of them. I have to really keep concentrating, because I probably just want to stop and watch all of them.
To replicate the size and shape of the stage at the Royal Albert Hall, an East London studio has been chosen for rehearsals.
Nobody wants their names called over the mic, like getting lion, no, down on the wrong count.
Important that we make a good impression and that we know, show them that we do know what we're doing.
Yeah.
The ballet staff begin with the two iconic swan acts.
Starting from today, we can have all the leg warmers off.
Where 60 swans, including the 30 newcomers, take to the stage to create intricate lines and formations.
Everybody has a different way of moving. You've got to get them moving the same.
Then we go, and up and down.
It's really hard at the Albert Hall because we've got not one front, but we've got three fronts. So where normally dancers have to stay in a line in a proscenium just looking at the girl in front, they've got to look at the girl in front and the girl on the side. And then when they're moving around, they have to be at certain places on the stage. It's a hell of a thing to ask dancers to do.
The white line, okay? All the way.
way around. That's the edge. That's the edge of the Albert Hall. And then each lino, that's what we call the cracks. So most of the time we line them up on those cracks. So now she's got to run up the crack. Oh, she missed it. Wasn't good.
You've got up and down. Could you just go
up? If anyone goes that much out, it just destroys the whole thing. So it's got to be completely together. Painstaking, boring for them. Yeah, the process, but it's got to be done.
5, 6, 7. Okay, here we go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Better.
Company dancer, Adelaine Kaiser, is performing in the Swan Dance. It's her first major appearance since she had a knee operation a year ago.
It's just gonna be my first ballet back in a tutu and make me feel like a ballerina again. But when I kneel, I feel sick. It's terrible. Because it's a patella tendon, you're kneeling right on it, and when you come back from a surgery, kneeling is the last thing that comes back, and it's not a very nice pain.
Adelaine uses padding to protect her injured knee and receives regular acupuncture.
It's really swollen, I think.
Pressure of the floor when you're kneeling.
On the knee.
And even the knee pads don't help.
No.
I suppose it's because such a direct and you have to go down so quickly.
Yeah.
Okay. And that's one of the problems with the dancer. You tend to dance full out for a couple of minutes and then stand in awkward positions or kneel in awkward positions for a period of time, and so the muscles all get set, but it's the pressure. You've just got to try and keep you ticking over.
You know, when you come back from such a big injury, and there you ask yourself so many questions, you know, and I think if you don't really love it and if you don't really want to do it, then you would give up, because it's such a hard work getting up every morning. It's really hard and mentally and physically. So I guess I want to do it because I'm still dancing.
Injured or not, the Swans have to complete another 3 weeks of daily 7-hour rehearsals, sometimes running up to 8 miles a day. After 3 days of dancing, Derek decides to visit the Swans to judge their progress, leaving Vadim to rehearse with his principal staff.
Derek has a certain aura. He can be intimidating. He'll always speak his mind. If it's crap, he will say it's crap.
I hate the word bully, but I do bully them, but I bully them in a constructive way. My name is above the title, and so I am, at the end of the day, you know, I'm responsible. You know, sometimes it makes your stomach turn over. The responsibility is quite scary.
Very sad. Better feeling. Again, keep the bourrée going, keep it going. Don't give in on the bourrée. Shh.
It's important for me to show them that I can do Swan Leg because it's the last ballet of the season. I just want to show I can do it.
Flat backs, ladies. You look like turtles. She hasn't changed legs.
Get down, 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 down. Get down.
Who's Adeline?
She's got a real problem with that knee.
God almighty. What is the reason she can't do it?
She's had a patella operation.
Oh, she's had an operation, okay.
So, yeah. Okay, ladies.
And is it likely to damage her if we make her do it? Okay, let's not make her do it then. If they weren't here, I'd say let's make her do it, of course.
I'm a bit worried about Adeline. She's wearing knee pads for rehearsals, but she obviously can't wear knee pads for the show because that will look a little bit obvious. Just a little bit worried she's not going to make the whole run.
She's never going to make it, that operation girl. She's limping away.
We can't have a gap. Everyone, the audience counts 60 swans, and it would ruin the pattern. There's only 59 swans. I mean, no pressure on Adeline, but actually, we do kind of need her on there.
With only 2 weeks left of rehearsals, the swan dancers are being practiced more than any other. There can be no drop in intensity, as they are watched by the ballet staff from every angle.
Fighting with the pain in your toes, your knees, trying to hear the count, trying to be in line and not to stand out in a bad way.
Stay. Stay.
I've been holding out really well up until the last couple of days. Well, now I've got really bruised toenails, and then there's a lot of kneeling. You slide down into kneels, and each time when I slide, I take a bit of the skin off.
I don't think it will ever be comfortable, but it will get more and more doable and enjoyable. I have really big bunions, and I have blisters on them, so I need to save my feet for tomorrow. Everyone goes through pain, so you just have to forget about it.
After 3 weeks of rehearsing alone with Derek and Daria, Vadim is performing a solo for the first time in front of the whole company.
I think he's shy. I think it's a nervous thing, and he doesn't know me. You see, I must scare the shit out of him.
He wants from me more, so he wants from me more and more. It's get really hard and hard, and then you have to repeat again and again.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. This is Vadim's last chance to practice his solos before his partner for opening night, Polina Semyonova, arrives from Berlin tomorrow, replacing Daria.
You know Polina, you did it last
when Polina. Yeah, vaguely, yes.
You know, the beautiful, I mean, Cindy Crawl, I mean, so mature, that's what I'm worried about. I'm just worried about him looking like a boy, do you know what I mean? Because he doesn't know how to walk, he doesn't know how to stand, he doesn't know how to say good morning, you know what I mean?
And the more I'm performing with Vadim, the younger I feel. We just have this special connection.
Use your back.
Same sense of humor.
Go.
Of course, it is a little bit hard, you know. Get a little bit jealous that you know, I have to share with him. I'd rather have a partner for myself, because there's a little bit of insecurity in me thinking that he's not going to like dancing with me, that he's going to think that I'm a bad dancer. But I guess it pushes me even more to be better. I want to enjoy every second of it now, till I still have it.
1, 2, hold the arabesque, plie, show the arabesque. Use the head.
While the dancers rehearse, managing director Craig Hassel invites key staff on an away day to find a solution to the threat of government cuts.
If the government said, we need £600,000, what could give?
We could very easily cut quite a lot of costs by doing fewer performances on tour, couldn't we?
Hmm.
But what's
but that's
the point
what we
of
do.
Us?
Yeah.
Yeah.
How much per week, roughly, on a major ballet like Swan Lake or Sleeping Beauty, do we lose?
Invest.
I think that's important, because we get funded to tour. It sounds madness that every time we leave London for a week,
yeah,
costs us £100,000.
So to save £600,000, we have to lose 6 weeks touring, for example.
We only have about eight.
And then we lose the justification for our funding. Yeah, so then we lose our entire grant.
Yeah. Arms down.
The meeting is interrupted as Andrew Morgan, director of operations, receives an important message from Paulina.
No, Paulina.
She's supposed to get a visa yesterday.
She didn't.
She didn't, basically.
She will possibly get the visa tomorrow, and then we can fly her out of Berlin or Dusseldorf into London, and she'll arrive for Thursday.
That's tight. I mean, she'll be fine. It's just Vadim, but poor guy, having to, he'll be thrown on with her.
He's 20, and we have to take care of them as well.
Yikes.
Well, I'm, a bit concerned, really, because we don't have our prima ballerina at the moment. She's delayed because she has no visa on her passport, because she's Russian. There's a possibility that she might only arrive on Friday, but, I'm very concerned for him, being so young and being so inexperienced, that he doesn't get the proper time with her, and it's already short, So, anyway, we'll see. Tomorrow's another day.
It's Friday, and there's still no sign of Paulina. It can take months to perfect a partnership, but Vadim has just 5 days.
It's get a bit late and late, so I get a bit more nervous. I mean, we didn't dance together yet, never, but as I know, she's really tall. She's much taller than Daria.
All he can do is wait and watch videos of her performances.
It's going to be really different to partnering. So everything when I did with Daria is going to be completely different with Paulina. So it will take time. I hope we can put everything together in 5 days.
What could be a problem? They're both very, very different physically, Daria and Paulina. Paulina is so much more expressive physically. Daria, she's in the autumn of her career, let's say. Her body still works very well, but she does have limitations because of serious injuries.
You might be on Wednesday.
If you pay me like you pay her, yes.
I'll give you her fee. We're all hoping that Paulina's going to make it. She will be here probably, but it's rehearsals they need. Yeah. And he'll be panicking. And she could arrive today. Or not.
If she doesn't get away today, we're looking at possibly flying Derek and Vadim to Berlin to rehearse on Saturday and Sunday, and then they'll come back to London on Monday. But it's just a bit of a waiting game at the moment until we find out whether her visa is going to be approved or not. Because Vadim is Russian, he needs a visa to go into Germany. So it's not as simple as putting them both on the plane tonight to Berlin.
Time is running out for Paulina. If she doesn't get her visa today, she will not arrive in time for the opening night due to a national holiday. And Daria will have to step into the breach.
Yeah, I'm feeling exhausted. But actually mainly because I haven't slept last night. A bit, just tiny bit stressing, It's getting a bit closer. Because, I'm worried I'm going to do opening night, which I don't want to do. I know it sounds really strange, but, in my age, I don't need all this. And, you think after 20 years, if I'll do one more opening night and critics will see me, that I just will become a star suddenly? I don't think so. It's important for Vadim, but not for me anymore. I just want to enjoy myself. And, the less pressure, the better. Well, I just know she will get the visa, I know for sure. Because I am not doing the opening night.
Even though Paulina hasn't arrived, Derek has a busy schedule rehearsing other principal dancers.
Do this. Derek says this is what it is. Do it.
So we don't have anybody going, no, I don't know what that is, or I never did that. Just unnecessary anxiety for everybody, as if we haven't got enough anxiety without the ballerina being here, you know, trying to rehearse four or five different casts. We just don't need any other problems.
Different casts play different nights through the two-week Swan Lake season, and each cast must learn the same steps.
Go! 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 And you go now, go! And a kiss! How come I know it? How come I know it? End of kiss into hug. Have a look.
I know you need a visa to travel to Germany, and I'd heard that you'd applied for a visa to go to do a gala in Prague, and I just wanted to check if you'd actually got a visa for that.
Wait.
Yeah, no, I didn't get it.
You didn't apply for it?
Yeah, didn't.
Okay. All right. That just makes it impossible now.
God almighty. Just impossible.
Andrew gives Derek a final update before the weekend deadline.
I mean, it's 3 o'clock in Germany, and the visa office closes at 5. So there's, you know, I mean, we've got a minute, but it's hardly likely. I just don't think it's going to happen on Friday afternoon, so.
Okay, well, you're not going to Berlin then, so if she doesn't get it today, what's going to happen? Did anybody talk to you? No. They don't talk to dancers.
Vadim has been called for an emergency rehearsal at the Royal Albert Hall.
It looks amazing.
This is the first time he's ever been to the venue.
We have lost Polina for the opening night. And, you know, I was hanging on for as long as I could to try and see if we could get her here, but unfortunately the visa didn't come through today, so she wasn't able to fly. So, darling, I have an early Christmas present for you. A very early Christmas present for you. You have to be on there, darling, on Wednesday night. Yes? What do you mean, what have I done to you? What do you mean? Tell me.
I'll do my best.
Of course you'll do your best, absolutely, and more.
I'll try my best.
You'll do your best and more. Daria is a very good dancer. She's a company ballerina. You know, she will go on and give a very good performance, I'm sure. It just doesn't have the same element of excitement for me because I'm not working with the two artists that I put together. So I lose the buzz and I lose my energy because it's not really the picture I wanted.
Very nervous, actually. When I came here, I expected he's going to be absolutely horrible to me, but I'm ready, you know, I'm ready for the worst rehearsal in the world.
Centre, stop. Tiam, ta da 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 dee da 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 dee da 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 da. Stop, stop, stop. Yeah, you're really in the wrong place. You should be right over here, kids. You know, with somebody who takes over from somebody else, you know, the expectations become greater. Look at the leg. But yes, a lot of hard work has to go into this rehearsal tonight to get anywhere near what I will be satisfied with as a performance. One and a two. Oops. Slower and slower and slower and slower and slower. We won't be out before midnight. you have to look at it also psychologically, because you can damage the person rather than build them if you're not careful with them.
Vadim, Vadim, here.
Vadim.
Here. You have to do what I tell you to do. Yeah? Everything I tell you to do, you must do. Do you love her? Look, do you love her? Yes, I love her. I've told you 1,000 times now. The story is being told all the time. It's so important. You know, 48 hours to go, and I'm still telling you the story. Everything we've worked on, I want to see. And I'm seeing a quarter of what I want to see. Yeah? You got to a really good level, and then you just let it all go again. Soutenu! Arabesque! Promenade! Unbelievable, and I have to watch it. 2, 1, 2, and 1. Oh, I'm so fed up.
I'm quite an insecure dancer, but here, deep inside me, I'm ambitious. I just not gonna, you know, give up just because I'm insecure. So I just go and fight it, all this criticism and all that, and I just want to go and prove him, well, yes, I can do it. Even if you are screaming at me, I can do it.
Paddington Station, isn't it? A foggy day in London town.
Okay.
Yeah, obviously everybody thinks there's too much smoke. Yeah, so let's just get ready.
The company are preparing for the dress rehearsal, and it's the last chance for the Swans to impress.
Elephants, elephants. Listen to the shoes, elephants.
Look across, Lara gone too far. Stop.
Against the odds, Adelaine has made it to the Royal Albert Hall, in touching distance of opening night.
And it's been very nice to be back. I'm not performing my 100%, but, you know, it will be coming. You know, I've been holding on pretty well. I mean, it's been hard, and you know, I'm not gonna say it was painless, but like I enjoy it more and more.
It's not bad, actually.
No.
It's actually not bad.
The dress rehearsal feels like opening night, with a large invite-only audience. The dancers will perform this production to a live orchestra for the first time.
There's no room. So, you know, there's 60 of us back there. We're all in the same tutus, and you know, you remember who you're behind by their colour leotard or their hair, and suddenly everyone's got a bun in and it's in a white tutu, and you're like, oh my goodness. Before we run on, every time there's like, where is someone? You know, it's just constant chaos.
Holding the positions, I think, is worse and harder than actually dancing, because it just aches every muscle. And you can get pins and needles in your legs, or they can start to get cramp, and it's really painful. And you can feel sweat pouring down, and you get, sometimes I get an itch as well, but you just can't move, you just have to let it go and let it all drip down.
Some of the students look like rabbits in the headlights. They're a bit like, oh God, I've moved too early, then they jump back, all the back people went duk, 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 and then all of them had to try and space themselves out, and it just looks unprofessional.
Oh, so slow.
There are also issues with the orchestra, who are playing at a different tempo than the dancers are used to.
Da-da.
Oh. It's the first time the music director has seen the pace of the full performance, as he was unable to attend some earlier rehearsals.
But to actually be conducting without having attended any rehearsals is outrageous. Tempi's all over the place. Too fast, too slow, too in between. We spend weeks and weeks and weeks on this, and then a conductor walks in on the last day and just completely wrecks the whole rehearsal. All the diverts were wrong tempo, I just gave him such a bollocking in the interval.
Yeah.
We had such a row, and he knows he's wrong. He just knows he's wrong because he couldn't say anything to me. Yeah, I said to him, you know, why are you coming here? How are you coming here unprepared? I've watched a DVD, he said to me.
Did he really?
Yeah. Beginning of the pas de trois was so slow.
That was very slow.
You know, there's many things.
Actually, they could deal with that.
Yeah, but it's not the point, Wayne. It shouldn't be like that.
But, Derek, unless you want, you know...
He has to be here for a week.
But he's a good conductor, you know. He's done it before. It's not like...
Yeah, but he doesn't look like a good conductor in my eyes.
I know. But, I mean, he is experienced, and he's done Swan Lake a lot. With a live orchestra, it will be different every time, and every conductor will be slightly different.
A dress rehearsal is just that. It's a rehearsal to make sure that the costumes work, that the music works, and so the rather tactless way that any issues were addressed to me, they hit hard, but then I decided to just let him blow his hot air out. You know, this is a ballet company. We're not a war factory. We don't make armaments. We're an arts organization, and we should behave like one.
Oh, God almighty. Look at her. In for the dreadful, absolutely dreadful. Maina, I'm not going to give her corrections. I'm just not. I don't mind talking to him. It just wastes my time talking to her. I'm not going to do it. There is so much to correct. There is so much to change. I can't be bothered. It's awful. I'll spend an hour with him if you like. And I'm not going to waste my time on people who don't listen and who don't care. You know, I'm very nervous about tonight because there are a lot of elements that I don't feel are really that secure. Ladies, enjoy. Good luck, everybody.
Yeah,
lots of smiles. I'm worried about some of the dancers. You know, we have problems with casting through injury. We had to take one girl out of a certain number because, you know, we just felt that she wasn't really ready for it and up to it. Good luck, boys. So she had to be replaced. I've traveled the world to find you. All right? Yeah? Enjoy, you know, really enjoy it and be calm and be collected, elegant.
Yes.
Think of all the other things except the dancing.
Yeah?
It shall be very good, very good. Enjoy it.
Thank you.
Where am I going now?
Swan Lake is a box office success with a sellout crowd of just under 5,000. Some have flown from across the world to see the guest star.
No disrespect to the current ballerina, but I didn't want to just see Swan Lake. I wanted to see Polina Semyonova dancing Swan Lake.
To be honest with you, yes, I didn't want to do Swan Lake ever again, actually. You know, I'm a member of English National Ballet, and actually we cannot choose which role we can do and which role, you know, we don't want to do. So I thought, well, if I want to basically stay in the company, I have to do Swan Lake one more time. And I would like to do Romeo and Juliet in the autumn. So I thought, okay, well, I'll fight it one more time and I'll do Swan Lake.
Ladies and gentlemen, would you please take your seats?
So do you enjoy doing Swan Lake?
No, it's one of my favorite ballets, don't take me wrong. It's just so hard, you know, and when you get as an older dancer, you lose the arabesque, and there is everything about arabesque. It's, you know, it's much harder for me than it used to be.
What's arabesque?
Arabesque is when you have the leg at the back. You know, when you lift the leg to the back, that's called arabesque.
And what, how does it feel when you do that?
Pain, terrible pain for me. Physique doesn't go forever. Sweat a lot, and it actually expands quite a lot with you, so if it's too loose then it feels a bit unsafe at the front.
It's Act Two, and 60 swans are gathering in the wings for the famous lakeside entrance.
Yeah, some of the other girls have gone a little quiet because they're a little nervous, I think.
This is the most important act, so I wasn't nervous up until now. Yeah, no, very sick. Feeling composed-ish.
Like right at your face, so you can actually see people's faces and everything.
Have you opened a bottle of shampoo?
No, it's as good as, if not better, than it is ever done.
Do
you think? Well, I do, because there's a kind of drama.
Yes, yeah, there's a lot of drama going on.
Act Three has begun. Vadim and Daria are about to dance their most challenging part of the ballet, the Black Swan Pas de Deux.
Maybe it's my last swan leg ever, so why not to try to give one more time everything? Only a couple of fuetes. But I feel young. I feel like I'm 25. Seriously. Might not look like, but I feel like.
And they say we work hard.
So I guess maybe that's why I'm still here.
For the finale of the routine, Daria must complete the famous 32 fouettes, where every perfect turn is counted by the critics.
Did you do that?
Good.
It's been such good fun. It's been really good. It'll be really sad when it's over. I really, really don't want it to end, and it's definitely made me think this is definitely what I want to do and do kind of for the rest of my life, really.
He was fabulous. And she really came up. She really did come up. Bless his heart. Oh, 20 years old, just out of school. Bloody amazing. Bloody amazing.
It's all. I think it's when, all right, yeah, I'm really happy. Really hard. But it's over. I mean, I think second time gonna be easier.
Daria was amazing. She always comes up with the goods on the performance. She keeps us guessing.
Yeah, I was so tired. At some moments, I didn't know what I was doing.
But... She looks so vulnerable, and they enjoy dancing together. So it becomes something really very special.
By the time you got to the third, it was very good, very good. You've got to go over the top in the fourth act.
Mm-hmm. More than this.
Yeah, but you're not going over the top. No, you say even
but
more.
But it's so hard.
Yeah, but you're not. Yeah, but no, so you have to do it. You have to do it. You have to flap. You have to suffer, or else it doesn't look like you're trying to be desperate to stay alive. Good.
I'll keep trying. It's very hard to please Derek. It's very, very hard to please Derek. But if you please him, it means something. But you know what? I'm happy. It was the first show, you know, and the first show is usually the worst because it's just the start.
Ladies and gentlemen, congratulations on a fantastic opening night. We will see you tomorrow for class on stage at 11:30.
Guest star Polina Semyonova eventually performed 6 days after opening night. Rachel is still training for her first professional contract. Since Swan Lake, Daria and Vadim have become English National Ballet's number one partnership, with their performances winning rave reviews, comparing them to Nureyev and Fontaine.
Romeo and Juliet's unique. It's not a love story in Rudolph's production. It's the whole story is about death.
We're short of boys, so we have to be very careful with them.
As I came to step in, caught the blade instead of my hand.
Already this week we have 3 guys off.
It's swelling a bit, I'm afraid.
One thing that's going to happen is there are going to be cuts to the arts budget.
We have to at least look at redundancies.
There's only 1 week left. Now we can start to do bad cop and get them scared.
That's a ball breaker.
And Agony and Ecstasy continues at the same time next week. Next tonight, stay with us for our Saturday night film. Keira Knightley and Sienna Miller star in The Edge of Love.